So you've heard a lot about game engines and how they power the great gaming experiences that you love. But game engines can be complicated at first look, and learning exactly what they do and how they are used in development can be a daunting task. In this video, we will remove the mystery by explaining what a game engine does, how they came to be, and which tools they typically provide to game developers. You will learn your way around a typical game engine and learn to evaluate what engine is best for your project based on the different features they offer. We are Ask Gamedev, and this is Game Engines Explained. Welcome back! If you're new to Ask Gamedev, we make videos to help you learn about the games industry so that you can elevate your games and inspire others. If you're on a game dev journey, consider subscribing. We'd love to help you out along the way. So what is a game engine? At a high level, a game engine is a software framework that developers use to create video games. Engines provide tool sets and content pipelines across a variety of commonly used game areas, graphics, audio, and code scripts. These tools allow the developer to quickly create game experiences without having to recreate a lot of conventional infrastructure. There are lots of different engines available to developers, some free and some paid, and many development studios have their own custom-made engines that only they use in-house. Additionally, many engines allow for customized extensions, and developers can build layers of technology that sit on top of engine tech that are owned by other entities. It can allow a development team to extend their capabilities or improve their development efficiency. We recently did a video on the best engines available. Check it out by clicking the card above for more info. The different game engines available will all have their own unique features and customizations, but most share a common set of functionality. First, they typically house the main game program that defines the game logic and different states that the user will experience. They also typically support the graphical appearance of the game through a rendering engine. Audio is often also supported through an audio engine that defines what and when sounds get played. Then there are lots of other common game elements such as networking, physics, AI, and others that have become regular components of modern engines. We'll get into the details of each area later, but first, let's start by talking about the history of engines and what has led us to today's landscape. In the early days of gaming, developers had to create their game tech from scratch. Back then, most gaming was done on consoles or desktop computers, and the specific game information was housed on a cartridge or disc. The art and audio assets were loaded from the media, and the game logic would have to tell the console or computer when to grab these assets and how to deploy them on screen. The game would then have to delete these assets from memory once gameplay no longer had need for them, so that memory could be freed up for future gameplay assets. The instructions behind all of this work and more was typically written from scratch each and every time a game was developed, and it was inefficient and slow. As you can imagine, there was real interest in simplifying the game development process by building frameworks that would remove the need to recreate all that code from scratch over again. This increased development efficiency and speed meant that developers could create games quicker and with more frequency. The framework approach has since expanded to virtually all areas of game development. Engines provide shortcuts that touch all commonly used parts of game dev. With that increase in functionality, engine costs have continuously decreased over time. And now you can choose from a wide selection of great engines for free. We recently did a video on the best free engines. Click the card above to watch that now. Some of the more decorated engines of the early days of gaming include 1991's Wolfenstein 3D engine by John Carmack and id Software, which created the first-person perspective format that helped shape modern gaming. 1993's id Tech 1, or the Doom engine, was the engine that presented a huge step forward in computer graphics and spawned Doom and its early secondary releases. The Build engine, released in 1995 by Ken Silverman for 3D Realms, and is known for the Duke Nukem 3D title, amongst others. This engine was one of the most prolific first-person shooter engines of all time and established new standards for maps and movement. An X engine, released in 1995 by Bethesda, which was a breakthrough engine for 3D development and was used by early Terminator and Elder Scrolls titles. What do you think was the most impactful engine of the early gaming days? Let us know in the poll above. So now that we know about how engines came about, what can we expect to see offered in modern game engines? Well, for starters, graphics, or the visual representation of the state of the game on screen. As mentioned earlier, use of the rendering capabilities of the engine will dictate the appearance of the game. This can include the display of 3D models, textures, animations, and other varied asset types. It's common for artists to create these assets in separate applications like Maya, 3D Studio Max, or Blender. while the engine provides an integration pipeline that supports the file formats from those popular programs. But supporting art asset file formats isn't all modern engines do. Rendering capabilities have become a competitive area in development tech, with in-engine lighting and effects functionality now making AAA quality visuals accessible to small development teams. CryEngine, Unity, and Unreal are among the competitors trying to capture the market of developers targeting AAA visuals, and the bar is very high. Now let's talk about user input. Engines account for user input usually via a variety of different input types, like keyboard, mouse, controllers, or touchscreen gestures. The game engine provides intuitive ways to capture input events like button presses or key presses, and then trigger elements in the code that might display actions like running or jumping on screen. This is game interaction at its most basic. Another core element of game development is the addition of sounds and music to gameplay in an effort to invoke emotion and feeling. Similar to graphics, audio assets are often created in separate applications like WYS or Audacity. The engine then provides a framework for easy integration of audio assets into the build, with support of the commonly used file formats. If you want to learn more about how to get great audio and sound effects for your game, we recently completed a video outlining the best audio sources. Click the card above to learn more. Online multiplayer has been a staple of modern games, and many of the leading engines have integrated networking frameworks to allow for easy integration of social features. Whether you are developing a two-player turn-based game or a massive multiplayer online title, you will have to implement a networking solution that will allow all players to retain the same game state. This can be particularly complicated given that players can have different hardware, connection speeds, or network quality, and reducing gameplay lag is a complicated process. Many engines now come equipped with scripts and components that alleviate much of the pain with client-server connection, thereby allowing developers to implement multiplayer technology without having to create complicated network infrastructure. The next area of engine focus is scripting, and this can be a huge time saver for developers. Engines typically offer a variety of pre-built scripts that define behaviors and can be attached to various objects in gameplay. This can include the triggering of events like moving of a character or camera, or lighting the game environment, or the generation of particles. These time-saving scripts can also be as simple as importing a content asset into the game world. If you can think of it, there's probably a script out there for any behavior that you can use in your development. Artificial intelligence is a common development area where scripting is useful. AI is used for defining non-player character behavior, and scripts typically use behavior nodes to help streamline this process. Need to make a slick user interface to accompany your great gameplay? Many engines have tool sets for easy creation of screens and HUDs. Design the layout and look of your buttons, drop-down menus, sliders, and other UI elements, and then tie them to input events that drive different elements of your game with scripting options. There are countless UI authoring tools out there, and many are already supported by the major engines, so you don't need to use a native engine UI solution if you don't want to. The choice is yours. Now on to physics. Realistic-looking physics is important if the game is to recreate lifelike movement. World objects need to behave as if they're being affected by gravity or other forces, and that's why modern engines allow for the application of physics to game objects. Popular physics engines like Havok, Box2D, and PhysX are often supported in the popular engines. These engines handle the mathematical process of making the game elements mimic the real world. A more recent addition to game engines have been the accompanying asset marketplaces. These marketplaces can offer 2D and 3D art, animations, music, sound effects, code scripts, and virtually anything else you can think of. These marketplaces are of huge benefit to indie or solo developers who no longer have to learn how to create audio or art if they want to release a title. Unity and Unreal have two of the largest asset marketplaces, and we imagine that most engines will eventually follow suit and offer similar options. If you want to go beyond the asset marketplaces to learn more about how to secure great art for your game, we recently completed a video outlining the best ways to get art assets. Click the card above to learn more. So there you are, all you need to know about game engines. Thanks for watching, and let us know in the comments if you have any additional questions about game engines. Also, let your fellow viewers know if we missed any criteria for evaluating a game engine. Don't hold back, the viewer community needs your opinion. If you do like this video, consider hitting the like button or subscribing as we publish new content every week on how to elevate your games. Hit the bell below to be notified as soon as a new video is available.